17. It was a very good year. It was a very good year for small town girls and soft summer nights. We'd hide from the lights on the village green. When I was 17, it was a very good year. It was a very good year for city girls who lived up the stair with all that perfumed hair. And it came undone when I was 21. When I was 35, it was a very good year. It was a very good year for blue-blooded girls of independent means. We'd ride in limousines. Their chauffeurs would drive. When I was 35, but now the days are short. I'm in the autumn of the year, and now I think of my life as vintage wine from fine older cakes. From the brim to the dregs, it poured sweet and clear. It was a very good year. Thank you.
old Sassy Brown. Lovers ain't in France when they swing to romance, because it's all so good. Yes, Sassy Brown, I'll say to you, like the French people do, Mama, it's so good. Oh, yes. Every boy, every sigh, every kiss, dear. Each to only one thought, and it's still, oh, it's so good. Nothing else replace just your slightest embrace. And if you only would be my own, tell the rest of my days, Mama, whisper your praise. Yeah, Sassy Brown.
Thank you. about 50 or 300. We have made it to another milestone, and if you are in reasonably good health, you have a lot to be thankful. I especially look forward to Friday and Saturday nights at the Green Gremlins. If you did not attend the dances at the Green Gremlins, you missed some real good times. I did not know how to dance when I first went there, but thanks to Phyllis Barnes, she told me the basics, and from there on I hardly missed a night at the Green Gremlins. I did not know, I guess that all of you attending this reunion also have found fond memories of HHS, otherwise you wouldn't be here tonight. The committee has decided to spend monies on, have decided not to spend monies on prizes or entertainment, so as to keep the ticket price reasonable to encourage as many as possible to attend. And I think we have accomplished our goal in that respect, and this is the largest group we've ever had. We thought that the time would be better spent on renewing friendships and to talk and visit with as many classmates as possible. Now, we did have some time out of the just after we finish our sit-down dinner. However, we will show some slides of our past reunions and our famous hula dances of our 20th reunion. Stick around for that, you all understand. We asked that you send or bring with you any pictures, slides, etc. that you may have taken at past reunions and share them with us tonight. So if you did, please bring it to my attention and we will get to display them or show them. To all the wives and husbands of this class of 47, we want you to feel that you are part of this class too. Please do not isolate yourselves from the festivities. Take this opportunity to make new friends and have an enjoyable evening. To all those who made the extreme effort to attend this reunion by traveling a substantial distance and incurring additional expense, we give a special thanks. I'd like to read some of those people who came from out of state. Starting with the states that are closest to New Jersey, Connecticut, Mr. and Mrs. George Egon, and Mr. and Mrs. George Tweet. From Massachusetts, Mr. and Mrs. Leonard Light, and Mr. and Mrs. Robert Sexton. Pennsylvania, we have Mr. and Mrs. George Woodsma, Mr. and Mrs. Howard Ignor McMillan, and Mr. and Mrs. Allen Ramella McIntyre, and also Mr. and Mrs. William Potashnik. From Maine, we have Mr. and Mrs. William Wempe, South Carolina, James Fox Boyd, Vermont, Mr. and Mrs. Howard Schwenker, Virginia, Mr. and Mrs. Milton Crow Heidi. Well, I should say Heidi Crow. Florida, we have Mr. and Mrs. John Van Cooten, Ms. Bullard, Jesse Delander Trindle, Mr. and Mrs. Colin Flint, Maureen Hutchison Bertoni, Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Burt Mitchell, or Mitchell Burt, that's the way it should be, Maureen Jean Link, or Maureen Jean Zimmerman. From Illinois, Mr. and Mrs. James Adamo. From Michigan, we have Mr. and Mrs. Douglas Shumway. Texas, Mr. and Mrs. Donald Elliott. Arizona, Mr. and Mrs. Nicholas Manella. From Washington State, Mr. and Mrs. Frank Simon. Barbara Schottmeyer Limbaugh. And I think it's only befitting that we give Barbara an award of participation. countries, and monkeys can come back great business, we will award them the Grand Blue Ribbon Prize. That's what you get when you come in at the last moment. Okay, as inevitable as it is, death has taken its toll on some of our classmates. We have on display a memorial picture board of those known to be deceased. We miss them, and maybe when our turn comes, we will see them once again. Our thoughts go out to them this evening, and also to those who could not join us tonight. May we have a brief moment of silence to acknowledge their missing. Thank you very much. This is the last reunion that this committee will put together. So if any of you are interested in holding another reunion, please bring it to the attention of any committee member, and we will see that you get all the information that we have to date. It's a lot of work, but it's also fun. I guess we've had maybe 8 meetings over the course of the year to put this together, and there was a lot of laughs at times. We've done a lot of work this time, so if anybody does take it over, you have a good base to work from. And speaking of committee members, I would like to thank my fellow committee members for the time and effort to make this reunion memorable. I would say please give a hand to Virginia Felicio, I call Jimmy Bird Dog for being so tenacious and tracking you all down. Telephone calls, mailings, etc. Jimmy did it all, and believe me, she lost a lot of sleep in doing this. So hopefully tonight will be her first good night's sleep in the whole year. And we have Ann Rotondi Dinello. Ann would not stay for any old place, believe me. We had our go-arounds several times in order to get a good present the whole place to hold this. Another must was a Vietnamese dessert table. We could not hold this without that, and Ann saw it was, and that's what we have tonight. As well as being a right hand to Jimmy and helping her with all that Jimmy had to do. Now we have Florence Hinger, Gravantine. Florence took on the job of making the name tags for wearing, as well as decorations, copies of the voice, and any other reproduction work that we needed, and her husband Ralph was also indispensable. Now let's go to Mike Vermilio. All I can say is Mike, having been the mayor of Hackensack a few years back, has a wealth of contacts which helped us immensely. The band for one, and the ties for another. Mike was usually great to get into the meetings, but he made the meetings. I'm telling you, for a retired man, he is one for himself. Now let's have a word about Nick Noble. As you know, Nick being a drummer, he tried to keep his role in time. But alas, Nick kept leaping through the yearbook, checking out all the pretty girls. But he did come up for air when we needed him. Kirk Wyman? Kirk does not say a lot, but when he does, everyone listens up. You get no bullshit from Kirk. Assistant Kirk, his wife Marie Wong. She is the glue to this committee, as well as past committees. Like Jane, she is a tireless worker and pursues everything, crosses all the T's and dots the I's.
Over and over.
I guess the only guy left is yours truly, Fred, and wondering. Professional photographers cover this reunion, which we have. And I volunteered like an idiot to MC this tonight, which is my first. So I hope my public speaking teacher, Miss Lynn Ford, can be a wee bit proud of me tonight. If you have any questions, suggestions, or constructive criticism, please see any of the committee members. We are privileged tonight to dance and listen to the music of 14 accomplished musicians. They are known as the Memory Lane Orchestra. And isn't it a pleasure to dance and listen to all our old favorites? Pleasurable music does not have to be played with the aid of booming loudspeakers, as you have heard. So after each set, come and hear your appreciation and show everybody the black flag. Grass was mowed. Coke was a cold drink. A pot was something to cook in. We certainly were not before the difference between the sexes were discovered, but we were the last generation that was so dumb as to think that we needed a husband to have a baby. No wonder we got confused and there was a generation gap. So that is reason enough to celebrate. Did you know a meaningful relationship meant getting along well with our cousins? We were before house husbands, gay brothers, computer dating, dual careers. And we never heard of tape decks, electric typewriters, word processors, and guys wearing earrings. For us, time sharing meant togetherness, not computers or condominiums. Hardware was sold at the big stores like Sears and Roebuck and Saints, and software wasn't even a word. The 5 and 10 cent store was where you bought things for 5 and 10 cents. Woolworths and Baumgartner sold ice cream cones for 5 cents and 10 cents. And for a nickel, you could make a phone call, buy a Pepsi or mail a letter and 2 postcards. The White Manor and White Diamond sold hamburgers for a nickel. A chip had a piece of wood. Women tell me even the material in women's dresses is getting skimpy, especially around the waist and hips. Even people are changing. There are so many younger than there used to be when we were their age, and on the other hand, people our age are so much older than we are. I even ran into a classmate the other week, and he changed so much, he didn't even recognize me. And as I was getting dressed for tonight and saw my reflection, I realized they don't even make mirrors like they used to. We were before television, penicillin, polio shots, microwaves, Xerox, contact lenses, credit cards, Velcro, laser beams, ballpoint pens, pantyhose, drip-dry clothes, and split atoms. Do you remember when you got married first, then lived together? How quaint can you be? Men walked on the moon and outer space was the back of the Fox Theater. I guess at this point I would like to call upon Mr. Crowe to say a blessing for this evening's meeting. Mr. Crowe? Mary Jean Height.
Bear with me another minute or two, and then we can get on with the dinner.
Would Frank Simon please come up, please? I tell you, you don't come all the way from the West Coast.
Double time.
You know, we spend a nickel across our 3 miles, and we appreciate it.
Thank you. Just to make them feel good, but I was really hurt
mention their names to embarrass them, but their initials are Coke and Rewind. Anyhow, we have had such a great time together, and my wife and I decided Christmas is coming up, and we're going to shop just for each other at the same store. We're both going for Victoria's Secrets, and we're going to buy each other lingerie. Hey, if it's good enough for Walmart, it's good enough for me. And talking about Christmas, it reminds me that I never realized it, and maybe a lot of you people don't know, why there is an angel at the top of the Christmas tree. And I just found out a couple of weeks ago why that was. It was Santa Claus was getting ready on Christmas Eve to deliver all the toys and presents around the world, and before you know it, he found out that all the elves had died of stroke. They hadn't finished the toys. They wouldn't load up his sleigh. Three of the reindeer came out of the flu. Rudolph got so whacked out his nose didn't even blink a little glow. And his wife started howling. She says, you know, every year it's the same damn thing, you know. You go on and you deliver all these presents, and I don't see you for a couple of days, and I spent Christmas Day all by myself. And he was just happy. About that time, this little angel came in and said,